Hi there, welcome to Kevy Shades. Very nice to see you, nice to be back here. Right, this is a little bit of an unusual shave. I only have one day's growth. Looking at that, you probably can't see anything, but you can hear. Yeah, there is something there. I don't usually shave daily, but I thought, right, okay, it's the weekend, it's Saturday as I film this, let's just have a shave. I've been recovering all week. Thank you very much, by the way, for all your kind wishes after my slip on the ice. Someone left a comment saying, sorry to hear about your slip on the ice, but you'll probably feel it the next day even worse. And boy, did I feel worse the next day. I woke up, when did the last shave go up? I think it was Monday. And I woke up on the Tuesday and my shoulder and my whole side was like, I was like, oh, it was really painful, sore. I couldn't hardly lift my arm. So I have been shaving, but just not on camera because it's quite uncomfortable. But it's getting better. It's okay now. It's not too bad. My hand is healing up, as is my arm. But I've got a little bit of bruising down my side, so it's okay, but all good. I'm just lucky I didn't hit this empty egg. I was going to say it and the contents would spill out onto the pavement, but it wouldn't because there's nothing in here, as you know. Look at this guy laughing. Right, okay, let me show you what we're using in the shave today. A new razor from the Global Shave Club. Thank you, Sheldon, for sending this over. This is the Diablo Super Slant by Global Shave Club International. You can see it on the head there. Yeah, look at the head of this. It's absolutely massive, really chunky. You can see the slant there. Yeah, it's a three-piece razor. I'll take it apart like that. There's the handle, nice knurling on it. It's not the best made razor. You can see some of the flaws in that, in the production. It's not perfect by any stretch of the imagination, but it is what it is. There's a spec sheet for this, so I will put that up on the screen. It gives you all the weight and stuff and diameters and lengths and stuff, so I'll put that up right now and you guys can take a look. Right, so that's the spec sheet. As I say, three piece, comes apart like that. But this head, look at that, it's a monster. It actually doesn't feel too heavy. It's a little, it is a little bit heavy towards the head, but it's pretty well balanced. About there, I would say. Maybe there. Whatever. it's head heavy. It is head heavy. Right, okay, the blade I'm going to be putting in that, a blade I've not used for a long, long time. Favourite for many, many shavers, an Astra Superior Platinum or Astra Green. And I think this is one of the old style blades. Astra changed their blades. I think this is an old pack I have. Just let me get the blade out. They used to print on both sides in bold print like that. But I think they've changed them now and there's just one side. Probably just to cut down and save on costs, but there you go. So this is the last one in that pack. So it goes on the head like that. Now, there's a little sheet, by the way, that comes with this. That says, Diablo Blade Alignment. Align your blade with the bottom plate of the, what does that say? I don't know whether we're going to call this razor this, the geodesic head. The head cap is not flush with the bottom plate. So it says that there. So, and I'll show you what they mean by that when I put this blade on. Oops, so broke the sink. Right, so that's the base cap and the top cap together. I'll just screw this handle on. And if you check the alignment of the blade, now to me, look at that. That doesn't look right, but it says that it doesn't sit flush with that. So look, there's way more exposure at this end than there is at this end. But because of the way the slant is, I guess that's how it works, right? Okay. Right, I'm going to start the shave with some of the Ice Tube, which is the mentholated cube in the stick version from PAA. Very kindly sent to me from my cousin Vinny over in the States. Oh, I'm dropping everything today. So it comes like this. It's a, you can smell menthol. A nice, well, it's not a nice scent, it's just menthol. So I'll just wet the whiskers. As I say, a bit unusual, just one day's growth. And yesterday I shaved and I nicked the top of this and there was a couple little dots there. So we'll see how we go today with this razor. Yeah. So I think that's all I would need from that, from the Ice Tube. Yeah, a little bit of menthol in it, you could feel it. I wet my hands and then just rub this in. Yeah, so it's like a, just like a face wash, but it works really, really well. How you doing? How's things? How's your start of this year? How's that all going? Yeah, we've both myself and Mrs. Kevy have been in the wars this week. She was grocery shopping the other day and she opened the boot of my car. I guess you guys in the States call it the trunk. And it didn't open fully. And she turned round, got the shopping bags, went to put it in the boot of the car. Bang. Hit her eye, so she's got like a black eye just now. Oh, it's actually her glasses that you can see the mark where the kind of nose rest of the glasses just in here. But it looks painful. So she phoned me up and she said, can you get some ice ready? So I've banged my head. So she has a little cut here on the bridge of her nose and she has down here, it's all bruised. Oh, but she still looks beautiful. That's all that matters. Right. A new soap for me today, one that I've not used before. Lots of people have used it, I've just never tried it before. And it was very kindly sent to me by David, so thank you mate. And it's this TFS, which is Chung Fung Sing, which is an Italian soap. The guy that makes it is Chinese, well, originally 1945. And this is Bergamotto Neroli, so Bergamot and Neroli. It has a nice, I don't know what that image is. Looks like a square in Italy somewhere. With a horse and a chair and a dresser of someone ready to shave. Yeah, so I've not tried it before. Here it is here. It's a nice scent, Bergamot and Neroli. That's what it is. I'm going to be bowl lathering that in the Kevy Shaves bowl. I've not used that for a long time. So I'll just scoop some out from the side. Just about that much. And I shall just spread it into the bottom of the bowl. Yeah, I've not used this soap before. Don't know anything about it. Lots and lots of people on, I looked on YouTube and there's lots of people who've used this soap. Say it's very good. It's it's been on the go, been getting made from 1945. They've not taken that long to make this particular one. That's how long they've been making soaps. Yeah, it took 1945 he's been working on this soap. Let me show you the ingredients on the back. Some guys like to see that. There we go. Okay, so let's put the lid back on that. So there's the soap in the bowl from that little bit of soap. Right, the brush today. An old friend of the channel and a brush that I've not used for ages and ages and ages. And I'm sure you'll be delighted to see him and I'm sure he will be delighted to see you. This is the Big Stirling Kong, or AKV,
Where the hell you been, pal? I've not seen you for ages and ages and ages and ages and ages. I'm ready to whip up a ladder. I've been sat in that drawer waiting for you to pick me up, Kevy. Where on earth have you been? I suppose you've been using all these fancy badger brushes and PAA amber light aero or whatever. But I'm the big Stirling Kong. You better use me more, Kevy, or you'll be getting the old oof. Take that.
I don't know. So it's a, this is a 26mm synthetic brush. There he is there.
What have you done, Kevy? You've messed up all my hair.
Shut up. Right, we'll just go right into the soap. Straight away, lathering up. Frothy bubbles. We'll just keep working it. Working it. How are your shaves going? Are they going well? Are you using new gear that you maybe got for Christmas? Look at this. Yeah, lovely citrus scent from that. Little bit of water I'll put in there. Bergamot and neroli. Now, in case you're wondering what neroli smells like, it's a kind of like an orangey floral. It's really nice. Oh, you're doing well there, Mr. Kong, Mr. Stirling Kong. Look at this, spilling out the bowl. Absolutely superb. Yeah, I don't think this isn't a, it's not an expensive soap. I think it's widely available. I've said it a million times, these Italians, they know what they're doing when it comes to soaps. Soaps and colognes and, yeah. That's really nice, look at this. Look at this. Look at that. Beautiful. Right, I think that's whipped up enough to bring to the face. Right, let's just rinse my hands off. So, as you can see, look, the ice tube is still there. Yeah, not much stubble to work with, but here you go. Look at this lather. Yeah, it feels nice and creamy. There's lots of it in the bowl. Just that little bit of soap. Yeah, it's a nice scent. It's not really, really strong, but you can smell it. Lovely. Citrusy scent from the bergamot. Bergamot's a citrusy scent, and the neroli just adds to it. Very nice. Just make sure I've got enough on here. That looks good. Right. Let's go with the Global Shave Club Diablo Super Slant. Yeah, look at that head. As I say, that blade alignment, just that looks wrong, doesn't it? But here we go. Let's see how this feels. Mild. Yeah, that feels nice actually. I think Sheldon and Global Shave Club are trying to take over the world. If they, the amount of razors they have. But that's good for us shavers. Gives us more choice, right? Right, okay, I need to be careful with this, this bit of... I went over yesterday. Yeah, just try not to, this little spot thing. Just try not to take the top off it again. easy to find the angle with this. It does feel mild. I think it says it's a 2.5 out of 5. And they compare it to the Merkur 37C, which is the slant, and the Parker semi-slant. If I'm being honest, the Merkur and Parker are nicely finished, better than this. But I guess at the end of the day, it's the shave that counts, right? That's what you're looking for, and this is performing very well. Right, let's see how this head gets on. Get the thickness of that. Going under the nose here. Too bad. Yeah, I thought I would really struggle getting under the nose there, but it's okay. Look, it's a, yeah, I've got that little one down there from yesterday. Right, okay, first pass done. That soap feels fantastic, really good slickness there. Right, let me rinse and come back for the second pass. Okay, nicely rinsed off. Yeah, can you see that line on my nose there? You know what that is with? I stand in that shower and I cover my face and then I rub my nose and start doing this and it causes a little bruise. I don't know why, it always happens. It's because I stand and go ugh, and then I start rubbing my nose for some reason. It's very comforting. I don't know. There you go. Right, that feels good. Right, let's go back to this. So look at that. That's lovely. Yeah, just a nice standard soap that works. It just works. It's just, look at that. You can't complain with that. They've got lots and lots of scents. Chung Fung Sing. Second pass across the grain. Yeah, lots of scents on their website. Yeah, this razor feels pretty mild. Two and a half out of five, probably about right. There is a little bit of overhang at the just at the sides here, tiny little bit, so just be careful of that. I know a lot of people, when they see the name Global Shave Club, they think, oh no, no, another razor from Global Shave Club. But to be fair, there's a market there for everyone. I'm just lucky I get to show them off and use them, try them. Yeah. They are what they are. They're not the most expensive. They're not made of the best materials, but they work. Most of the time, they just work. Right, just be careful of that, Kevy. Ah, I've just caught it, look. Slice the top off again. Right, I'll get the styptic at the end of this pass. Actually, I'll get it now. Let me just get the styptic pencil. Yes, here. So I'll just wet this in some cold water. Put that over there. Yeah, it's just that little one little dot. I don't know what it is. It's not a mole. It's just like a little skin tag blemish. I should have been more careful, but there you go. You have the tools there, so use them.
Here we go.
Set that there to dry. Yeah, so that should be that. Pretty much stopped. Look at this razor. Yeah, what was I saying? Oh yeah, I'm just lucky that I get to try all these different razors and show you guys them as well. You know, everyone can't afford or doesn't have the means to buy the latest, greatest stainless steel, titanium razor. So, always good to have options. Right, second pass done. That feels great. No slickness there because the styptic's on. Right, okay, let me rinse and I'll come back for the third pass. Okay. Yeah, that's it. That's really... alum and the styptic take away all slickness. So, look, you can see that there. Look. But this side's slick, so we'll get some soap on this face again for the third pass. Yeah, so as I said, I shaved just yesterday morning. And I've been shaving this way for about 5 years now. 5 years ago, if you'd said to me, you think you'd be able to shave like one day after the other with a cartridge razor? No chance. My neck would be like, I would be like I had chicken pox. It would just be full of little dots. It'd be a rash here, down here. Going against the grain on my mustache would have been a absolute hell. But, yeah, for those of you just starting out, you maybe got some stuff for Christmas, stick with it. Use all these nice products that you see people using on YouTube and Facebook and Instagram. All these artisan soaps with great ingredients in them. They really do benefit your skin. And just try out as much stuff, different stuff as you can. Obviously within your means. Don't fall down the rabbit hole. What's the rabbit hole, Kevy? You'll find out. Yeah, it's just... yeah, I came over to this way of shaving to save money. £20,000 later. Right. Before I start this pass, I want to mention two channels on YouTube, which I will put links for in the description. First one is called CB Shaves. CB is Chris, he's a guy from Wales. Paul H's neck of the wood. I think he's a good friend of Paul's. Go check out his channel. The other one is a very new shaver. I think he's maybe got 3 or 4 videos from Greenland. You don't see many shavers from Greenland on YouTube. Sig Solo is his name. I can't remember what his YouTube channel is, but I'll put it on the screen right now. That's the name of his channel. So go and check both those guys out. Tell them that Kevy sent you. Give them some support. And yeah, all the best, guys. It's good to see people. The more YouTubers, wet shavers, the better, in my opinion. Yeah, we all have to start somewhere. I had to start somewhere. I'm lucky I've got a good following now. Lots of people comment. I thank you all for all those comments. But everyone's starting out. Need support. There's lots of people out there. So I know it's difficult to watch them all, but yeah, it's just good to just mix it up and just go and watch different people. So Chris and Sig, all the best to you lads, and good luck on your channel. Right. I need a rest now. I'll get the money later. Right, look at this lather. Superb. Right, let's go against the growth. Are you shaving up there? No, not today. Yeah, you have to learn this way of shaving. Light touch. Light touch is always needed. And if you do that, that takes a bit of getting used to as well. Especially coming over from cartridge razors. Not pressing down on the skin. Just using a light touch. Right, let me just get some hot water onto this, because that feels cold. There we go, that's better.
Right.
Pardon you. Weeper there. Yeah, a lot of people think slant razors are more aggressive. They are a little bit. A little bit more efficient, shall we say. Right, I'm going to just watch this this little dot. Right, just leave that there. Yeah, look. Corners of the mouth, always happens. Yeah, that's okay, cold water will sort that. Yeah, so this razor is, it says on the sheet 2.5 out of 5. And that probably feels about right. It doesn't feel aggressive. Feels smooth to use. Not as smooth as some razors, but it's not rough by any stretch. Right, have a quick rinse, see what's needing picked up. Oh, that's cold. Right, probably be this, yeah, tiniest bit there. Not much else actually, just a little bit down here. That's all it needs. Yeah, you can just hear that there. It's got it. Tiny bit there.
Right, that feels great.
Right, nice. Right, I'm not going to use alum today, just going to leave it. I'll get some cold water on it, but first of all, I'm going to have a face wash with this soap. Do you see how much soap's left in this brush? And there's still some in the bowl, which I will gather. Yeah, look at that. That's a really good. Nice peaks on that, nice shine to it. Right, let's have a face wash. So anyone new, this is what I like to do with the leftover lather. Rub it into my face. Good stuff in the soap. And I leave it on while I clean my gear out. Then I'll just dip my hands in the water, start rubbing it in, dip my hands, rub it in. And then, once that's done, try and pat my face dry, and come back for the post-shave. So I'll see you in a moment or two. Nice shave, really good. Close, comfortable, yeah. And that's it, I shaved yesterday. Again, it feels really, really good. Right, post-shave. Straight onto the aftershave. There's a little bit left in this. Proraso Green. Eucalyptus and menthol. Good standard stuff, just a good, good splash. I have this is the old bottle. I have the reformulated bottle as well, but I wanna get through this one. Nice little bit of sting. Nice. There we go. Put the lid back on. And a Balm I've not used for a while. Does anyone remember Suffolk Shaver? Steve Keir. He got me this Balm when he was in the States. I still have it. Still works. Good stuff. Aqua Velva. Sensitive 5-in-1. You just need a tiny amount of this, just that much. Little goes a long way. It has a sweet scent, kind of, but nice. Yeah, very good. Good stuff. I've not seen many people use that actually, the Sensitive 5-in-1. Maybe going out of fashion a little bit. There we go. Swipe my hands. Good stuff, there we go. What do you think? Pretty good. That's 2 days in a row shaving. And no irritation. A couple little dots here and there, but cold water sorted them out. Right, let me show you what we've used again in today's shave. I really sound like a kids' TV presenter. Let me show you what we've used again in today's shave. First of all, we used a razor. The Global Shave Club Diablo Super Slant. There it is there, just look at the thickness of that head. Now this has a safety razor. This has a razor blade inside it, so don't use razor blades, children. what am I doing? I don't know. Right, the razor. Global Shave Club Diablo Slant. Very, very head heavy. Yeah, the balance is about here. yeah, it's not the best made razor. There's little flaws underneath it, but it works. It does the job. It's a slant razor. It's quite mild, I would say. Quite a mild slant razor. Slant razors are usually efficient. They don't feel aggressive, but this one comes into that category. 2.5 out of 5 it's supposed to be. And I would say that, just look at the slant on that. Looks great. Yeah, but massive, massive head. Nice handle, nice grip on it. So thank you, Sheldon, for sending that through. We started the shave with the PAA Ice Tube, the methylated pre-shave. Good stuff, I love this stuff. It's very, very good. Just the right amount of methyl on it. We bowl lathered, sorry, the blade. Let me show you the blade. The blade that was in the razor, brand new Astra Green, Superior Platinum. Not used these for a long time. Good blade in that razor, worked just fine. Just not too sharp, not blunt. It just worked. Good stuff. We bowl lathered in the Kevy Shaves bowl. And the soap was Chung Fung Sing Bergamotto Neroli. Pure crema dalla barba. Pure crema da barba. Yeah, an Italian shave soap. Very good. Scooped a little bit out from the side there. Nice scent. Whipped up the lather great. Yeah, good scent. Good cushion glide. Everything was there. It's just a nice... There's no bells and whistles about it. It just works. It's just a good, good shaving soap. I'll put links for everything. I think that's quite widely available in a lot of places, so have a look for it, but I'll put links for everything that's used today. The brush, the old friend,
And a big Stirling Kong. Thanks very much, Kevy. That was fantastic. I really enjoyed that, by the way. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I whipped that soap up like nothing else. Never mind your fancy PAA brushes and your badger brushes. I do the job quite well, Kevy. A big Stirling Kong.
Yeah, 26mm synthetic knot. Quite an old brush now. I like this kind of vase style handle. Very good. Good stuff. Three passes. We nicked that a little bit there, so we used the old styptic on that. Three passes, pickups, face wash, post-shave, Proraso Green, aftershave, a little bit left in that, eucalyptus and menthol, fantastic, and finished off with Aqua Velva Sensitive 5-in-1. And then we'll have it, ladies and gents. Looking good, feeling good, smelling great. Right, right, okay. I'm going to get this dried off. Right, okay, have yourselves a fantastic rest of this weekend. What's left of it, have some great shaves, use some great stuff. Just goes to show you don't have to use high-end stuff all the time. This was a pretty much a basic shave, basic stuff. All shaving's good. If you get a good shave, it doesn't matter what you use. If it's good for you and it works, that's all that matters. So there you have it. Right, have yourselves a great weekend. Stay safe wherever you are. The COVID here in the UK has went through the roof. Lots of new cases, lots of new deaths. It's horrible. So please, please, please stay safe out there. I want to see you all back here for the next shave. Okay? I want to see you all. Right, and go and check out those two guys' channels, CB Shaves and Sig Solo. I'll put links in the description for everything that I've talked about and used in today's shave. So until the next time, stay safe, look after loved ones, take care, stay warm, and I'll see you in the next shave. I love you all. Bye for now. Oh, that sounds like YMMV. Bye for now. Right, okay, I'll see you next time. Take care.